everyone. Jeff Smith here from InfoMarketerZone.com. It's the site where we share our dozen or so years of creating information products. That's how-to products. That's ebooks, self-published books, reports, membership sites, DVDs, seminars, and other training-type manuals. For over 12 years now, we've been helping businesses and individuals prosper with that type of business. And folks, there's one important aspect, or the one really killer aspect to how successful you can be, anyone can be, packaging information for profit and selling it online. And that is how you choose your market and how you choose your topic. And this, you know, whether you're a book writer, a freelance writer that's looking for the next project, or they're looking to get a book published, or whether you're trying to self-publish a training program that you want to sell online, either to consumers or business, the same thing holds true. The most important aspect is the topic that you choose, and that involves market research. And it, folks, you're looking at the main site that we have. It's InfoMarketerZone.com, which goes through six-week programs for teaching you the complete A to Z business for info marketing. But also, it goes into a lot of detail in how we actually choose markets, how we research markets, how we find those little hidden gem niches where information is selling like wildfire, but virtually nobody knows about it. And we're going to teach you to do the same thing. One thing I want to run through today is one of those techniques that we share with our insider members, and that is, if you think about it, when you choose a topic, you want to choose a topic where information is already selling. Now, people's habits and what they've bought in terms of books, in terms of direct mail packages, in terms of audio and video courses, are pretty much the same and have been for the last 100 years. People demand the same types of information. It's because the underlying motivation is what we want to be, have, do, or become in our lives. That's what we seek. When we go in looking for information on something, we want to achieve something. We want to be, do, have, or become something. And if you keep that in mind, it becomes a much easier business to dominate. So what we want to do when we pick a topic is we don't want to just start off with what we think people are going to want. We want to go and look at what people are buying. And that's why I like to go to places online and tap into where consumption of information is happening. And one of those places is Ezine Articles. Now, this is one of the top directories that organizes information for both consumers and for ezine publishers. So this is where massive amounts of information are consumed, and it's organized to make consumption that much easier. It's organized by popularity. So if you look at these are high-level niche market examples. We want to drill down into those. Let's just take the self-improvement one to show you, and you'll see all the different sub-niches within self-improvement. In fact, if you go into each one of these, you'll find even more sub-niches. So you'll find literally thousands and thousands of niche markets where information's already in huge demand. And so let's just assume that we wanted to take, what I would typically do here is I would take a few of these that I think are hot today, and I'd take maybe happiness, things like, let's see, what else have we got, innovation maybe, self-esteem. And I would plug those into a tool called Google Trends. That's the next thing we're going to look at. So if you go to google.com and then /trends, and I'm going to go ahead and just plug those in. There was happiness. There was creativity. There was innovation. And let's say self-esteem. And actually, let's just go to motivation, I think was another one there. And let's just take a look at what it's going to give us. You separate those by commas, they're going to give you a comparison of the searches done under those. And here you get a good graph over a period of 4 years about the searching trends, the search patterns for these keywords. And you'll see that of all of them, motivation is the highest. But you will notice some trends that are interesting. Say that happiness, which is the blue graph here, look at how it's been going up and up and up and up and up. It's almost doubled in terms of the number of searches. So when we look at this as a broad trending tool, those are the types of trends we can see. As opposed to innovation, if we look at that, it's been going down, down, down. So it's not necessarily the overall size of how many searches are done on the market. It's what are the trends? And you'll see motivation's pretty much stayed the same. It's gone down slightly. And even creativity has pretty much stayed the same, and it's maybe gone down a little bit. And so happiness is a good one. And what I would do then, you know, after I take a look at the trend, first of all, I'd want to see that there's a decent amount of search traffic for that keyword, and any one of these is a decent amount. And I'd want to see that it's trending up or at least staying the same. I don't want to see something that's trending down. So I would be very skeptical of this innovation graph. And then I would go into, after that, I would head over and do a Google search on that term. And what would I search for? Well, I would search for, let's just go right to the Google search box. I would search for a very telling set of keywords. I would always put in how to in quotation marks, because that's your exact match. We want an exact match on those two words. And then I would say how to, and then happiness. And what I want to see is how many courses come up, because what we've done here is we've found demand by going to the directory. Now, how else could we found demand where consumption of information is happening? We looked at Easy and Articles. That's just one of them. We could also look at magazines.com, which shows you different magazines. And you know, if you've got a specific topic in mind, if it's self-improvement, I would go to psychologymagazine.com and look at what their headlines are. They'll give you tips to the type of topics that people are consuming. I would look at existing book titles in Amazon.com. But to get my understanding here, to get my point, the point is you look at where information's already selling and you go from a consumption basis. Then you go to Google Trends and you look at whether those keywords, the ones you're selecting, are actually trending up. If you can find a combination of that where there's real demand and consumption of information and a trend up, then you go to this step and search Google for how to happiness. And there you'll see, you'll get some articles. You'll get a toolkit. Now this is interesting. I would go in here and you'll see that there's actually a toolkit for sale. That's good. You can even do how to happiness and you can say workshop, or you could say DVD, or you could say ebook, or you could say book, right? Any type of course, workshop, manual, and that will tell you whether there's different products for sale. What you want to see is a healthy supply of those. And so in this case, the happiness workshop, right, is one of them. Let's just see if there's anything else. There's a SlideShare show, happiness workshop. Here's life coaching. Some of these are going to be pretty interesting. So this is a pretty plain looking site. And this is the topics of the course. It's all outlined right here. Let's see. Oh, look at this. $999 per person. It's a one-day course from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., seating 10 per workshop, $999, so $1,000. I like to see these sorts of things. If you can see a number of these patterns of not only low-end information products like books and ebooks and reports, but if you can find high-end workshops and seminars and classes, then that also tells you, or even video courses where they're in the $200, $300 range, that tells you there's a very healthy amount of demand and supply in that marketplace. So if you can match all three of those, you've got yourself a decent topic. So I hope that was helpful. Use that approach. Go in and look where people are consuming information. And I didn't mention ClickBank.com is another place, Amazon.com, Magazines.com, or even just look at your local magazine store. Look at ezinearticles.com. Those will direct you to niches which are already in demand because there's consumers of that information already. Look for trend research, then come back, whack it into Google with some how-to and ebook just to see what your price range is and see that there's really some products selling for that. So I hope that was useful. You'll get more tips like this if you go over to infomarketerzone.com and enter your name into the subscription box, and we'll tell you when the next video is available. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye for now.